From Phoebus High School, It Happened, WHCS Cable Channel 5 presents Peninsula District Girls Basketball. The Phoebus Phantoms hosting the Hampton Crabbers. Good evening, everybody. I'm Tim Cole, along with Bob Hintz. We welcome you to Phoebus High School for this contest between the Lady Phantoms at 2-15 and the Lady Crabbers at 17-2 under the successful tutorage of David Six. And, of course, Phoebus in a rebuilding year with Liz Myers at the helm and doing a very fine job, I might add. This game tonight is brought to you in part by Wood Funeral Home with Richard Pulley as the funeral director, and also by Zoom's Sitco with 5 convenient Hampton locations. Right now, let's go down the court side where Bob Hintz has head coach Liz Myers of the Phoebus Phantoms.
Thanks, Tim. Liz, I know this is getting close to the end of the season, but your girls are starting to pick up a little bit of your philosophy now. What do you feel like the team is doing?
Okay, right now, if you remember from the last time, I was saying we need to be a lot more aggressive and take more shots and things like that. So right now, we don't have anything to lose. This is our last game, so I'm hoping that the aggression will be there as well as the shots and that we will make them.
So. Okay, now you're playing a team that's in number one, so you you really don't have anything to lose.
Exactly.
And Stephanie's not going to play tonight.
Oh, so really?
Okay. She had injured her eye, and I didn't know whether you knew that, so she's not even going to play tonight.
Okay.
But it's still, your girls have to be very aggressive, don't
exactly.
they?
Exactly. Yesterday, we only had 7 girls at practice, but I told them, just like you said, we have nothing to lose. There's no other game after this game, so they just need to come out and play this game the hardest way they possibly can.
Well, listen, congratulations on making it through the first year.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's go back to Tim.
All right, thank you, Bob, and our congratulations, too, to Liz. She's done a great job. The record does not reflect her efforts, nor the efforts of the young ladies on this team. By the way, speaking of efforts, the JV girls team from Phoebus had been shut out all season long, but just before we came on, they defeated the Hampton JV girls team by the score of 22-17. All right, let's go back over now to David Six and our good man, Bob Hintz, the Hampton coach from Hampton, David Six.
Thanks, Tim. David, I know this game should be pretty easy on paper because you're the number one team, tied for number one, but you still have things that your team's got to work on to keep mentally sharp, don't they?
All right. What we do is we're trying to work someone else into the rotation tonight, and that'll be Katrina for now. So it's going to be interesting to watch how she fills in for injured Stephanie Hicks.
I know Stephanie hurt her eye in practice. Got to figure out how is her status.
We're taking it day to day right now, and we'll wait and see what happens.
Well, listen, I want to again congratulate you on doing a fine job over at Hampton.
Thanks.
You really have. You're in the top, and I just want to see you go ahead and win that playoff and get that automatic berth.
Well, we're going to try.
Good for you. All right, let's go back to Tim.
All right, thank you. And again, I want to echo those sentiments. David Six with the Hampton girls team tied for number one with Menchville. Now, assuming that Hampton wins this game tonight, and then on Tuesday they have one remaining game, if I understand the schedule correctly. Phoebus is the only team that will wrap up their season as far as the regular season is concerned this evening. But if Hampton and Menchville continue to be tied after the final game of the season, then there will be a determination of a time and site for a playoff match between the Menchville Monarch girls team, assuming they continue to win, although they have a much tougher task. As you see the officials, Robert Dixon is our referee and McKeever Bird is our umpire for tonight's contest. But as I said, the Hampton-Menchville teams, if they continue to win and win their last two games, then they will have a playoff game, and a time and site will be determined as it dictates whether they need it or not. Bob, you were talking with David Six and Liz Myers, and certainly David has turned that program around at Hampton, and I'm sure Liz, with some time, will do a similar thing here at Phoebus.
Well, both of them are very excellent coaches, and they've got some great background. You know, Liz assisted Mike Talon for many years, and you know you can't assist somebody and not learn
something about basketball, and you and I know Mike Talon is a great teacher. David has just done an outstanding job, took that Hampton program from the bottom and brought them to the top in about 4 years. That's just outstanding.
And you may have heard Stephanie Hicks will not play tonight. She is not dressed out and will not participate in the game. Of course, I assume that if there was a contest of great magnitude, her condition might have been reevaluated. But this Phoebus team has struggled. They're 2-15. They do not, on paper at least, pose a huge threat to Hampton. Let's run down the starting lineups. They are not going to introduce them, so we'll just get right to the game here, and we'll give you the starting lineups right after we get underway. And we are underway. 8-minute quarters in high school basketball. There is no shot clock, and the rules are pretty much the same. Possession arrow will dictate any jump ball or situation of that nature for the balance of this game. They jump it one time at the very beginning, and then that's it. They get it down low. Bailey, check that.
And that was Miss Fennell. Yeah.
She's a tall young lady. That'll help Hampton as far as their rebound is concerned. They've got a pretty tall team.
She's 6 foot, Tim. She is and playing and starting that center position instead of Stephanie Hicks. And I was you could see the what David Six wants to do. Immediately, he got Vinny to get the ball inside, get your inside game going.
The turnover gives the ball back to the Lady Crabbers. They are in the dark uniforms, the red, if you will. And the Phantoms get the ball back after a Hampton turnover. We're just underway from Phoebus High School. The Lady Phantoms and the Lady Crabbers. Tim Cole and Bob Hintz bringing this contest to you. Videotaped on the 10th of February, 1995. Turnover. This is Vini, and she will score the first basket of the ball game.
She's an excellent ball handler. And Tim, she played over here last year for these Phoebus Phantoms.
Want to run down the starting lineups, Bob?
Sure, yes, we'll be glad to do it. For the Phantoms, number 11, Stacy Epps. Number 12, Katrina Cook. Number 21, Heather Rice. 32, Rashonda Ivy. And 42, A.J. Antoinette Jackson.
Underneath the offensive board, the Phantoms get three chances. Now they'll wisely pull it outside. This is Cook. She swings the ball around. Shot is good by number 21, Heather Rice. So the game is tied at two as Rice hits from outside.
And for the Hampton Crabbers, we've got number 10, Latoya Lassiter starting. Number 30, Juanetta Vini. Number 32, Nakisha Gilliam. Number 23, Katrina Fennell. And 44, Shonda Bailey.
Vini applying the pressure, and in doing so is guilty of committing the foul as she got a little too aggressive.
And Tim, I do want to, while we got a minute, do explain a couple things. We've got a couple girls for the Phoebus Phantoms that had helped them at the beginning of the year. They're both hurt. Sherry Reed, who you and I both have seen play for quite a few years, is injured and has been out for almost the whole season. And Letitia Thomas is another one that is missing for the Phantoms.
A whistle, and the Phoebus player had stepped on the out-of-bounds line. So the turnover gives it back to Hampton. Less than 2 minutes gone here in the first period. We're tied at two. There you see a good look at David Six, who's done a great job bringing this Hampton team to the top of the heap. 15-1 in the district, 17-2 overall. Long shot from outside is rebounded by the Phantoms. That is number 40, Tonya Williams. Phantoms work it down low, blocked underneath nicely. And making the block was Latoya Lassiter, number 10 for Hampton. This is Bailey. And Lassiter loses the ball to Rice. So both teams turning the ball over with great regularity here in the early going. Rice has a rim out, and Lassiter clears the board. This is Vini, left wing, one on two. Gets around the defender, can't get it to go, however.
That was a nice move, one that had put on, but she didn't convert. Both teams have been playing a zone, basically.
inside. The shot is short, and the rebound comes off for the Crappers. That was Fennell with the rebound. Loose ball, and we've got a jump ball. The possession arrow will give it to the Lady Crappers. Substitutions we'll find for Hampton. Did we get a number 3 in our chart there, Bob, for Hampton? I didn't see that name. Well, yes, I did. I'm sorry. That is Katrina Washington.
Katrina Washington and LaQuinta Palmer are two young ladies that became eligible at the end of the first semester for the Crabbers.
This is Miss Washington. Now they give it to Vini, and Vini is rejected down the lane, but a foul is called. Foul will be charged to number 33, Gail Jones. That'll be her first. And going to the free throw line with two shots will be Wynetta Vini. Coming in for Hampton is that other young lady we referred to, LaQuinta Palmer. And there you see a good look at Liz Mears directing her team from the sideline. Two shots as Hampton looks to untie this game. And Vini cannot hit.
And, you know, Tim, it's hard sometimes to get the young ladies enthused about a game when you're the number one team playing the team on the bottom, and you have a tendency not to play with as much enthusiasm and that you normally do. So this game could be a little ragged at times.
1 out of 2 for Vini makes it a 3-2 contest now with a little more than 4 minutes left in the first period. Nice steal. This is Washington, or rather Palmer, rather. And she can't get it to drop. And back come the Phantoms. David Six wasted no time getting the young ladies in that became eligible recently. Palmer and Washington. Good feed down low. Can't get the shot, however. And the rebound comes out for the Hamptons. They want to, Crabbers want to break. Beanie pulls up. No good. Offensive board, shot won't go. Another rebound and a foul inside. This one looks like it'll be called against number 32. That will be.
I think he called on 30 on. Well, maybe he's right. I thought I saw him put up more than 2 fingers at the end, but.
There you look at the Phoebus cheerleaders for just a moment. An intricate part of the sport. Crabbers almost lost it. They get it back. Down low, Vini can't get it. Got her own rebound. Blocked, but a foul is called. Looked like a pretty good block by Jackson, AJ. But she apparently got the arm and the ball. And the official makes the call. So Vini will return to the free throw line to shoot 2. 3:13 remaining in the first period. A reminder that we will have the boys contest between these two schools as well. That'll be airing on a different night here on Channel 5. And we invite you to watch that. Check Channel 5, the message board for the listing. Also in the Hampton Neighbors of the Daily Press. I understand that they have the schedule now, Bob. Is that right?
That's correct.
And speaking of the Daily Press, we want to thank Mike Keach and Jennifer Williams and all the fine writers over at the DP for providing us with statistics for not only this game, but all season long. We truly appreciate the sports writers and their contribution to us for our coverage. Again, both teams sluggish here. The Crabbers seemingly playing down to the competition so far. And of course, they are also are missing, as we mentioned, Stephanie Hicks, who is their leading scorer and main go-to young lady. Phantoms working the ball, looking to get down low, and the Crabbers doing a good job of denying that right now. This is Williams to Rice. Back to Williams. Williams drives, put it up. A little short, and Bailey rebounds for Hampton. Shanda Bailey, who has done a great job with the Lady Crabbers this year, might have taken an extra step there, didn't get called for it, however. Meany is open for a three, and she hits it.
And she's got all six of the points, doesn't she?
Yes, she does. And Meany will take that three. In fact, she just narrowly missed a three a little earlier. Shot will go, rebound for Hampton. Crabbers up by four. Stolen by Williams. And restolen by Washington.
It's like, you want the ball? Here. No, I want it back.
Less than a minute 40 off the mark from Bailey, and we've got a whistle underneath. Looks like a pushing foul against the Phantoms.
There's no 21. Oh, yeah, it is 21. I'm sorry. I didn't hear what Scotty said. Did you pick him up?
Unfortunately, I didn't either, but I will.
We're going to throw the three-pointer.
The three-point shot. This is Vini.
Here's the three-pointer.
And there you see another good net. We're back to the live action now. Shot from outside. Vini hits this time a two. With a minute 24 left, Vini steals, and she'll convert. So just like that, a one-man gang here. Vini has scored all 10 of the Hampton points. And now a timeout is called by the Phantoms with, well, the clock is running. And, of course, it's not supposed to be.
1:15. There's 1:15 left.
Yeah.
Well, let's see, what happens here, you better look before to count a timeout, because the time they put up there is the 1 minute for the timeout. It really confused me when I first saw this. And then when we get down to the end, you'll see the tenths of a second on that side of the score clock. But there's 1:15 left. And the reason I know that is because I asked the scorekeeper.
Well, that was a good move. As you see, Liz Mears intently instructing her young ladies. And again, we want to remind you that this first period is brought to you in part by Wood Funeral Home at Victoria Boulevard in Hampton. Richard Pulley is the funeral director at Wood Funeral Home. Also, Zoom's Sitco. Good friends of Channel 5, Zoom Sitco, with five convenient Hampton locations for you. Zoom Sitco, a year-long sponsor here on Channel 5. We appreciate their contributions.
And we hope you appreciate it and visit their five locations.
Absolutely. Shot goes over the backboard, and a ball goes over to the Lady Crabbers. 10-2 is the score, or perhaps you might go Vini 10, Rice 2. Vini has all the points. That's Gilliam in the game now. Vini will try, no good. Rebound stuck back in nicely underneath by Latoya Lassiter, and she has her first basket, and the Crabbers lead by 10. Less than a minute to go here in the first period. In the corner, Rice kicks it back out to Williams. To Cook, to Williams. Tight man-to-man defense being employed by the Crabbers. Crabbers tuning up for the tournament coming up. Nice move, and that will be a move that David Six will remind the young ladies not to allow.
AJ did a great job.
Antoinette Jackson with the basket. 3 seconds. I don't know that the Crabbers realize the time is running down, and she doesn't get it away in time. It went in, and it would have been a three, but it was waved off and was done with absolutely no hesitation by the official.
None at all. Tim, while we got this break, I do want to let the viewers know that we will pick a DC Engraving Sports Place player of the game from each one of these two teams tonight, and they will receive a plaque and a T-shirt. The plaque comes from DC Engraving and Buckwalter's Engraving. DC Engraving is located at Tab Square on Route 17, and Buckwalter's Engraving, of course, is located down on Kickitan Road. Dave Buckwalter, the owner. And the sports place is where the shirt comes from. That is located in Hampton Woods Plaza on Big Bethel Road. Dave Chubb is the young man there.
12-4 after one period. And again, this second period is brought to you in part by Zoom's Citgo. Five convenient Hampton locations of Zoom's Citgo. They've got your gas, they got your soft drinks, soda.
They can fill up the tank that's on your car or the one that's in your stomach, right?
They can take care of it all. Zoom's Citgo has what you need to get going. Phoebus trying to work the ball inside, has it go out of bounds, and it turns over to the Lady Crabbers. Well, no, they say it was
no,
nice
it was hit by there. The Lady Crabbers, yeah. The Phantom Girls thought it was the Crabbers.
And it is, in fact, now the Crabbers. Beanie, one-on-one. Williams got back and is guilty of blocking, so she'll pick up the personal. That'll be her first. Step to the free throw line. Here's a replay. You saw the blocking call, the most difficult call for an official to make. Was it blocking or was it charging? In this case, pretty good call of blocking. And Vini warms to the task after missing three out of four. She hits her next two in a row. And she now has 12 of the 14 points. Beanie, this time, is called for the personal foul, and if I have it correctly, that'll be her second.
Well, that is her second.
Tanya Williams will bring it across the timeline. She is picked up on defense by Gilliam, Akeisha Gilliam, a strong part of this Lady Hampton team. And we've got a three-second violation as the Phantoms, guilty of being in the lane too long. Heather Rice is getting set to check back in, and she will come in and replace Gail Jones in the lineup.
No, check Jones. That out. 23.
Yeah, 23. Asus Blackley faked me out on that move there. Looked like 33 was coming out.
She did too.
14-4 is our score. Just underway in the second period. Beanie makes it 16-4, and she is on fire.
She has a lot of moves, Tim. She handles the ball real well, can drive the baseline, can hit the outside three, can penetrate, take the short jumper. One of the better point guards in the district this year. And if people want to see a great game, the playoff game between the same Crabbers and the Lady Monarchs will be a good one because there will be a playoff.
Well, that is assuming, of course, that they both continue to win. And Mansfield does have a pretty tough game against Tab, I believe it is.
But yeah.
They're such a strong team that it's unlikely that Mansfield will lose another game. And as I mentioned, there will be a playoff in the event that happens. And it'll be at a site and time to be named later.
It will not be at either one of the two home schools. They will play at a neutral site. That is a good point.
Rice checks out of the game, and in her place comes Katrina Cook. This is Gilliam for the Crabbers, Davini. Gilliam down low, gets it inside, but it's stolen by the Phantoms, and then, unfortunately for the Phantoms, they turn it over on the travel.
Well, I tell you, they're doing a great job of triple teaming when the ball goes inside, because I know that they practiced all week to do that to Stephanie Hicks, and of course, it doesn't make any difference who's in there. They're going to do that.
And a pass too tall for Gilliam. Saw the look on David Six's face. I wouldn't say that that was one of the happiest coach on the peninsula at this moment.
Well, he doesn't want him to make silly mistakes.
And, of course, you rarely see a coach who is ever completely satisfied with the effort of his team, no matter what the score is.
Yeah, that's, you got a good point, Tim.
Appen getting set to bring back into the game Katrina Washington, and she'll come in for Nakisha Gilliam. So it's Vini, Bailey, Washington, Lassiter, and Fennell for the Crabbers. Cook, Rice, Ivy. And Jackson in there right now, along with Epps. Stacy Epps is in there for the Phantoms. Beanie will try it. Off the rim, no good. Offensive board is up and no good, but a foul is called. Shanda Bailey will go to the free throw line. Foul is against Heather Rice. Nope. Must be 1-2 because Rice isn't in there.
Yes, she is. 21. Okay. She's just now coming out, Tim.
Trying to sneak out before I can catch her. 5:09 left in the first half. 16-4 in favor of the Lady Crabbers. Bailey will get a second try. She misses the first. And again, we remind you that the Lady JV's team, the Phantom Lady JV Phantoms, Phantom Lady JV's, whatever you call them, they won their first game just before we came on.
And I
would have thought they
had
won the championship.
I had not heard such yelling and screaming carrying on. The fans were really pulling for them. And that was an overtime contest.
Baseline jumper, no good. Grabbers have it and get tied up. And the possession arrow will give the ball over to the Lady Crabbers. Triple teamed, scores nonetheless. 16 of the 18 points for Vini here in the first half. You know, being back here at Phoebus High School reminds me of the old days of Lakeisha Frett in that group. And I read a paper today where Lakeisha Frett will be on TV coming up, I think it's this coming Tuesday, on a delayed tape coverage on ESPN. The Georgia Bulldogs will be.
And they're ranked, where are they ranked, about 10th?
Yeah, they're in the top 10, I believe. So if you'd like to get a chance to see Lakeisha Frett in her sophomore year for the University of Georgia, that team doing a great job. The Phantoms trailing by 14, and then we've got a foul just across the timeline.
And that was on number 3, Tim, Katrina Washington.
That's
a little
her first.
Aggressive.
That's her first. Neither team over the limit yet, but they should be rapidly approaching that. You get 6, and then on the 7th team foul, the other team shoots 1-1. Nice move down the lane by Katrina Cook. So Cook makes it a 18-6 contest in favor of the Lady Crabbers. Of course, as we've mentioned before, the championship in the Peninsula District is so important because it's an automatic bye to the Eastern Regionals. You don't have to win or even be competitive in the Peninsula District Tournament. Once you win, you are automatically in the regionals. So that is a prize that is well sought after by both the boys and the girls teams. And of course, Hampton tied with Mintzville as tonight starts. They would like to continue their winning ways and get a shot at a playoff. That would be a heck of a game. Rebounded by the Phantoms. Offensive rebound for Phoebus. They can't get a shot away, however, but it finally is controlled by Ivy. Baseline jumper in and out. And stolen by Shanda Bailey. Bailey drives the lane and she is fouled before the shot, I believe. Foul, it will be charged to Katrina Cook. And I believe that is a player control foul. Nope, they say it's 1-1. It is the seventh team foul against Phoebus. So Hampton is now in the bonus with 2:33 left in the first. Shanda Bailey missed her only other try at the free throw line. It's nothing but net on that one. There's that shirt's got to be in the shorts rule.
That amazes you, doesn't it? I see the puzzled look on your face.
Bailey hits both free throws. And the lead now 20-6, 2.5 minutes to go. Cook. And the Phantoms turn it over. Heather Rice getting set to come back in for the Phantoms. Moving the ball around, looking for the low post. Now they move to a double high post. Clear out for Bailey, and her shot is too hard. But the loose ball is retrieved by the Crabbers. Lassiter with a quick shot. Quick like a rabbit on that one.
Yes, she was.
She just turned around and fired it. And a traveling call.
That was a great move if you'd have had the ball and was still dribbling it, but she knew what she wanted to do. She just couldn't make her body do it all while she dribbled the ball.
And that's why I never played basketball.
That's right.
Never could get the mind to work on more than one thing at a time.
Oh, you had trouble chewing gum and dribbling the ball, huh?
Oh, yes. Loose ball and taken by the Phantoms. They trail 22-6 with a minute and 20 left in the first half. And the pass is too tall for the newest player in the lineup for Phoebus. And we have a number 15.
No, it's number, as ours 13, that's Jennifer Nolder.
Oh, okay. Jennifer Nolder, who we saw play earlier against Bethel, I believe it was.
That's correct.
Last week, week four. Meany for three, no good. Inside of a minute to go in the first half. This is Nolder in the corner. Phantoms moving around. Cook drives the lane and scores. Katrina Cook has 4 points. And it's 22-8.
You got a little friend over there on the side of you that's keeping you awake.
Yep. One of the younger fans here likes to come down and check the monitor every once in a while. Shot doesn't go, but a foul is going to be called against Palmer. Get a chance to watch a replay of that last little bit of action. The pass was thrown over the head of Noder for the Phantoms. I'm sure she's glad we showed that on replay. Oh, Slow-Mo is back. Is that right?
Slow-Mo is back.
Ah.
Oh, do we say he's back?
Yeah. Yeah, he's back again. Look at this. He's going to show us another shot of the same play.
He can make him go slow, and he may go fast.
This time the girl caught it. See, and that's what you call real technique, is when you can do the replay and she catches it the next time. And from the corner, as we're back to the live action, Nakisha Gilliam hits the score column. I've always wanted to do that. Have you ever seen your favorite football or basketball team miss a shot or a pass? And then they say, well, let's watch that again. You hope the second time they
goes
they complete
in. Well, they need slow motion. Joe.
That's right. Well, it was two identical periods as the halftime has arrived. In the first period, it was 12-4. In the second period, it was 12-4. Double those scores is 24-8. That's our halftime score here at Phoebus. We'll return for the third period of action after a brief timeout. Back at Phoebus High School, a little replay of the triple by Wynetta Vini in the first half. That was her three, the only three scored by either team. Vini did, however, outscore Hampton individually. She had 16 points. She had 10 points from the two-point range. She had a three-pointer, and she was 3 of 6 from the free throw line. Total of 16 points. Latoya Lassiter had 2 baskets for 4. Nakisha Gilliam, a basket for 2. And Shanda Bailey hit 2 out of 4 free throws for her 2 points. And for the Lady Phantoms, they were paced by Katrina Cook with 4 points on 2 baskets. Heather Rice had a basket for 2. And A.J. Antoinette Jackson had a basket for 2 to total the 8 points that the Phantoms had in the first half. Identical periods for the Crabbers and the Phantoms, 12-4 in each of the first 2 periods of the contest.
Again, Tim, we will pick a player of the game from each one of these teams. It's a DC Engraving Sports Place player of the game, and they will receive a plaque and a shirt. Plaque comes from DC Engraving and Buckwalter Engraving, and the shirt comes from the Sports Place. David Buckwalter and David Chubb.
There you see the Lady Crabbers, and you see our official, our referee, Robert Dixon, and McKeever Bird, the Zebras for tonight's contest. Possession arrow will give the ball to the Phantoms to start the second half. And we will have our 8-minute third period is underway.
And the Lady Crabbers come out in a 2-3 zone. They're going to make the Phantom girls either try to get it inside or shoot that outside jumper.
Phantoms turn it over quickly.
And they're also in a zone. Nice skip pass.
Yeah,
I don't know if it was intended, but
I don't think so. The Phoebus defender had the ball glance off her hand right into the hands of Shanda Bailey, who scored the easy basket. And they turn it over again. The pass picked off by Lassiter. Vini drives the lane, puts it up off the glass, no good. Back come the Phantoms. Spotted our friend from the Daily Press here, Miss Jennifer Williams, here to cover the game tonight. And Vini scores. Travers score the first 4 points out of the blocks.
And they're in a 1-2-1-1 full court zone press.
Noder scores.
And that's the way to break a press, is you pass it, you don't dribble it. Good execution that time by the Lady Phantoms.
Cavers throw it away. Tonya Williams checks in for the Phantoms. Nolder will come out.
Nolder, just a ninth grader, Tim. She's got three more years. They brought her up from the JVs when they had a couple young ladies get hurt.
Behind the back pass to Bailey for the bucket.
Well, that was a nice pass, but even a nicer catch, because I don't know that Chanda knew the ball was coming.
Good hands on Bailey's part. Distinguished boys commentator guest, Pat Patrick, from the school board, here to join us for the boys coverage. He's going to just watch and enjoy the girls game here, and then when we do the boys coverage here on Channel 5, I feel like Dan Dierdorf and company.
We'll have the three of us talking on top of each other, huh? Instead of just you and me.
That's right. 30-10. Williams from way outside, can't get it to drop. Little more than 4.5 minutes remaining in the third period. Grabbers with a 20-point lead as Vini fakes, shoots, in and out. And the rebound to the Phantoms. In and out. And the ball on the tie-up will give the ball over to the Lady Crabbers, as Palmer and Washington will check in for Hampton. And Gilliam will come out along with Fennell. Again, the Crabbers playing tonight without Stephanie Hicks, who suffered an eye injury and probably could have played if it were a game of great importance, and her abilities would be sorely needed, but unfortunately, this is a rebuilding year for the Lady Phantoms, and as it would be, they have been less competitive as they have in years past.
Number 33, Leslie Jones, came in for Juanetta Vini.
Bailey had it and had it stolen. Phantoms move the ball around nicely. And as I say that, Jones steals. And a good block.
Oh, it was. Got all the ball.
Rashunda Ivy got the ball and caused the jump ball. And the possession arrow will give it back to her team. So the Phantoms showing that in spite of the fact that they turned the ball over, Ivy got back on defense and created the tie-up. And Bailey returns the favor at the other end. I tell you, as strong as Hampton is, Bob, if they can get good play from both Washington and Palmer, and both the young ladies seem to handle the ball very well, and that'll certainly deepen that bench.
Well, that's one of the things that Coach Six is hoping, that these two young ladies, he said that they would help him. And of course, when you get down to stretch and you're going to play the Benchville, you want to have a bench that you can go to, because Benchville plays full court up and down just like Hampton does, and I don't care how much good shape you're in, your legs have a tendency to go when your adrenaline is flowing. So it's nice to have a deep bench that you can bring your starters off and give them a good blow for a couple minutes, but then they can go back in and you don't lose anything.
Well, and you know, the other side of the coin is that by having a deep bench like this and having players you can go to and having, you know, the nucleus for a good five, those secondary players get some playing time and they get the experience that's necessary, not only for the current season, but for next year.
That's a good point.
We've got a foul called.
Has a good shot of Walter Brower in the crowd. He's got his Hampton boys here ready to go tonight, and the pressure's on his team. They are one game behind both Menchville and Kickitan, and they cannot afford to lose any to have a chance maybe to have a three or four game playoff.
Stacy Epps with two shots, hits the first. Big contest being played tonight over at Kickitan High School as the Warwick Raiders coming to town, trying to break that Kickitan 11-game win streak. And of course, by the time you watch this game, you will know the results.
And Tim, there's another instance of a team playing another team only one time. That's the only time that the Warriors and Raiders match up this year.
Three-pointer from outside by Williams. Tona Williams. Beanie gets the ball down low. Fennell can't get it to go in, and she is tied up. And the possession error will give the ball to the Lady Crabbers, I believe. A minute 37 remaining in the third period. Beanie with her foot on the three-point line doesn't get it, and the Phantoms will bring it back. And two in a row for Williams from downtown. So she puts six on the board quickly. And the Crabbers lead now has been chopped by seven consecutive points by the Phantoms, 30-17. Less than a minute to go. And the Crabbers have scored just 6 points in this period. While the Phantoms have scored nine. The Phantoms will inbound. 55 and a half seconds remaining in the third.
Well, it looks like Miss Williams found a spot over there in that corner, Tim.
They're going to keep feeding her if they have any anything at all to say about it. Till she
misses.
She's
back over there.
You know how the rule of thumb goes, you keep shooting till you miss.
There you go. And that time the Crabbers put pressure on her, so she drove to the basket and drew the foul.
Foul will be charged to Palmer. That's her second.
That was non-shooting. I thought she was in the act of shooting, but evidently the foul happened before the shot attempt.
Williams spots up for another long shot. Doesn't go, but the offensive board is stuck back in by Ivy, Roshonda Ivy. And the lead is 11. So the Lady Crabbers have lost nine straight points to the Phantoms, and the Phantoms can't hold it at the baseline.
Well, that was a good look to get to see the open player, but it was pass was just a little too far for Miss Williams. Crabbers are playing a little lackadaisical. They're just not really, doesn't look like their head's in the game.
Gilliam will shoot, no good. And the buzzer will sound, ending the third period. And the Crabbers have just 6 points to add to their total. While the Phantoms scored 11 points, and the difference after three is 11. 30-19. Again, we remind you that the boys' game can also be seen here as we'll watch some of the replay of the action from the third period. This is the three-pointer from Miss Williams. You see the form, excellent form. Great follow-through and a swisheroo.
Now, you can tell that style of slow motion, right?
That's slow mojo. Come out of retirement.
I tell you. Well, we need the big hitter. They're not afraid to go to the retired player. Is that a replacement player?
Yeah, that's right. He's a semi-pro guy now. Brought him out of retirement. All right, so the fourth period underway. The Crabbers, a very lackluster third period, and I'm sure David Six has informed them of that. Foul against the Phantoms, charged to number 42, A.J. Antoinette Jackson. This will be a shooting foul, as at the free throw line will be Katrina Fennell, or Fennell. How do you pronounce that, Bob? Do you know for sure?
I think it's Fennell.
Fennell?
Fennell. Her brother was one that played on the football team. How did we pronounce?
I think I mispronounced his name, too.
Well, you're consistent.
I'm consistent with my inconsistency. I'm going to call her Fennell.
All right. You got it.
And hopefully that's correct. I apologize ahead of time if I did mispronounce her name. So she gets both free throws, and the Crabbers have a 32-19 lead. Williams just misses, and the ball goes over the backboard, and it'll belong to the Lady Crabbers.
The Phantoms are still packing that zone inside. They're not allowing the ball to go inside. Liz Mears has done a great job of working on that zone.
And a foul called underneath.
And the only reason they got the ball in that time is because Juanetta penetrated and then dished the ball off. Sometimes you have to do that against the zone.
Jackson is called for the foul, her third. At the free throw line, here's the replay. You'll see the feed down low to Fennell and the foul by Jackson. Fennell does not hit the free throws. You'll get a second one, however. And she's good on that one.
And immediately the Crabbers come out in that press, Tim.
33-19. Double teaming the ball, almost turned it over.
Great job of going to the pass by Williams. Most ball players would wait for the ball to come to them, and she did not. She made that step to the ball.
Vini, no good. Williams with the rebound. Back come the Lady Phantoms. Is good by Epps, Stacy Epps. A basket and one of two free throws for 3 points on the night, and the lead is 12 with 6:20 remaining in the fourth. Fennell can't get it to go. Bailey rebounds, her shot won't drop. Loose ball picked up by Lassiter, it won't drop. Fennell follows, and she has fouled. The basket will count.
That was being tenacious rebound. That was about three offensive rebounds that the Crabbers got that time.
Here's the replay at the other end on the stick back just a few moments ago. Well, we'll go back to the free throws here. Free throw, I should say. I was noticing how tall the Hampton team looks, and it's accurate because Bailey is 5'10", Vini's 5'10", Fennel is 6 feet, Hicks is 5'10", Lassiter is 5'10". So the Lady Crabbers have good height, and they'll need that in the district as well as hopefully for the Lady Crabbers, the Eastern Regionals. Down low to Fennel, and they say no, she took steps before the shot.
That was a great entry pass, a no-look entry pass by Juanetta.
So the turnover, and it gives the ball to the Phantoms down by 14. Bailey gets the roll.
That's the shooter's roll.
So Shanda Bailey has 8 points, six of them here in the second half. Phantoms do a good job against the press, only to have the shot blocked by Fennel. Uses that 6 foot tall body to block the shot. And well, we should have another traveling call.
And Tim, that's what you try to tell players when you're practicing, as you pass the ball against that zone press, that you can get the ball down and get an easy shot rather than dribbling and letting the press move with the dribble. That was an excellent job that the Phantoms did that time.
Shot from the corner, a little too strong. And Lassiter rebounds. Gilliam with the board. Shanda Bailey is fouled by Williams, and that's one of those times when you say,
oh, no,
goodness.
I don't want to do that.
No, I didn't want to do that. And the worst thing is, if you're going to do that, you want to make sure the shooter doesn't get the shot to go.
Yes.
So just kind of a touch foul, but one of those oops fouls. And the basket counts, and Bailey will have a shot at a three-point play. Crabbers up by 16, almost halfway through the fourth period. Bailey will get one shot. And she hits nothing but the bottom of the net. Got to think about our players of the game here, Mr. Bob. Nolder checking back in for the Phantoms.
And I'm very surprised to see her play very much tonight, Tim. She's been sick and missed maybe three or four days this week out of school, had the flu. So I know she doesn't have a whole lot of endurance.
And Liz Mears does appear to be spotting her, using her for brief periods of time and then giving her a breather. Shanda Bailey. Miss Bailey with 11 second half points. And the Phantoms turn it over. Katrina Washington will trigger. Bailey gives to Palmer, and Palmer scores. So Lakita Palmer, just a recent activated player, gets a basket. She's played quite a few minutes tonight. 44-21. Shot is too long from outside. It was knocked out of bounds by a Hampton player, they say. Jump ball as Fennel just wrapped her arms around the ball. And
she looks like she's got about 6 inches on the young Miss Williams. She put her hands up.
and steps before the dribble. 2:53 remain. 44-21 in favor of Hampton as they will improve their record to 18-2 and a 16-1 district record with one game remaining. Beanie back in the game. Loose ball tie-up will give the ball to the Lady Crabbers on the possession arrow. Leslie Jones will come back in for Hampton. And she'll replace Fennell. Katrina Fennell leaves with 5 points. Palmer throws it up, and it was Bailey underneath, and she draws the foul. 2:19 remaining. We do want to take this opportunity to thank the fine folks here at Phoebus High School for all of their cooperation in our setting up and bringing you this contest. The Phantoms are always gracious hosts, and we appreciate all of their efforts.
Well, and of course, we want to make special reference to the athletic directors, Bill D. and Bonetta, I'm sorry, Miss Washington are the two ADs here, and they help us set up, and Scotty and all, we really appreciate it.
And speaking of Scotty and all, we want to thank our crew for their usual excellent performance tonight. Ron ESPN Baton down on the floor camera. Who was our other
camera? We got Tavir Glass, and our buddy Jerome Young is back with us tonight. We're glad to have Jerome back. And there's a good shot of Jerome there on this monitor. And of course, we got Bianca Petaway and Scotty in the trunk with their slow-mo.
Yeah, is Bev not with us tonight? Is that the? There's Jerome.
Guess so. I have not seen her, so I'm assuming she's not here.
Oh, she's here too? So Slow-Mo is just doing a cameo appearance.
Oh, okay. So Bev is here. Okay.
Nice feed underneath, and Tanisa McDonald gets her name in the scorebook with the basket. Less than 2 minutes to go now. The Crabbers 48, Phoebus 21. Final regular season game for the Phantoms. And of course, since only the top eight teams in the district make the district tournament, the Phantoms, for one of the very few times in recent memory, in fact, I don't remember the last time that the Phoebus Phantoms didn't have a girls team in the district tournament, but let me make sure of that. Yep, they are gonna be last at 2-16, so they will not make the tournament. Top eight teams, and of course now with Tab added to the Peninsula District this year, as Williams misses the mark, you've got 11 teams.
That's correct. Instead of having the two not making it, now you have three that will not make it.
These Lady Crabbers most definitely will be in the tournament, and the only thing to be decided at this point is whether they or Menchville will be the automatic first round by into the Eastern Regional. Now they'll still have to play in the Peninsula District Tournament, but they won't have to win it in order to go to the Eastern Regional. Of course, two teams go to the Eastern Regional competition from the Peninsula, both in the boys and the girls. The district champion, and then if the tournament champion is the same team, then the tournament runner-up will also represent the Peninsula District. Less than a minute to go now, and the ball goes over to the Lady Phantoms. Our players of the game
are
Hampton.
Well,
no huge surprise. Miss Vini with 18 points, although Shanda Bailey came on strong And Tonya Williams of Phoebus is going to be our pick for the leading player for the Phantoms. And again, very unscientific. Do not put a great deal of credence into the system by which we do this.
Yeah, please don't.
A fine effort made by several players on both sides, and certainly don't want to indicate that that was not the case. But we have to pick one from each team, and by golly, we did it. 16.9 seconds remaining. And you get a good look at Tanisa McDonald. And Miss McDonald has a basket and a free throw for 3 points. Again, we remind you that the boys' contest between these two schools can also be seen here on Channel 5. And we again want to thank our sponsors. Our fourth quarter sponsor, Zooms Sitco, with 5 convenient Hampton locations. Zooms Sitco. They've got fast food. They've got beverages. They've got gasoline. They've got candy. They've got milk, eggs. I mean, they got it all.
And they got smiling people.
Friendly people.
And Zooms, they do a great job with the reading program in the city of Hampton, don't they?
Well, they do. Great friends of Channel 5. We appreciate their support in athletics as well as academics. The Zoom Sitco people. And by the way, with the tournament coming up, we will have some coverage for you here on Channel 5. And if your business would like to find out more about being a sponsor, give us a call during regular business hours. Scotty Bowers will be more than happy to give you all the details.
And that's at 850-5366.
Well, they left that score on the board for about 1 millisecond there. I think it was 49-21. There you go. Thank you. 49-21 is the final score as the Lady Crabbers are victorious. And as I mentioned, improved their record to 16-1 and 17-2, excuse me, 18-2 overall. And the Phantoms finished their season at 2-16 in both the district and overall. So the final score again, the Lady Crabbers victorious 49 and the Lady Phantoms 21. For the entire crew and Bob Hintz, this is Tim Cole. Thanks for watching. Good evening, everybody.